subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
For almost a fortnight now, we've been transfixed on the buzz coming out of Mumbai. It began with a Scorpio, Mahindra Scorpio, being found in the street where the Ambani house is located in South Mumbai. There were gelatin sticks in the car. Now, gelatin sticks are not bombs. You can use gelatin sticks to make bombs, but gelatin sticks by themselves cannot burst or cause an explosion of any size. Anyway, there were gelatin sticks. There was also a warning note or a threat note saying that this is just the trailer. Picture abhi baki hai dost, not their words, I am just simplifying it. But to say that you give us this much money in cryptocurrency. Now, that cryptocurrency seems to be a favorite blackmailer's tool now, because most of us get emails once in a while. These are all fake emails or phishing emails saying, I have seen you do so and so, I know you do so and so, so give me so much money in cryptocurrency or I will do blah blah blah. So all you do is you keep on upping your spam filters a bit more to deal with this. In this case, this, if it was phishing kind of expedition, this came with gelatin sticks. Also, the location was very important. It was the street where the Ambani house Antilia is located. It's also a street where no ordinary people live. You would presume that there is high security on that street, that there is very good security in every building, there are cameras and the rest. Now, when that happened, it looked for a moment like a prank. When I heard this, I thought, oh, what is this? Gelatin sticks, Gadchiroli. So, contractors in the mining areas use gelatin sticks. Where else do you find gelatin sticks available in the private sector? So, maybe it was either some Naxals, or it was some people who were linked with Naxals, or maybe it was just a blackmail thing. Then the next thing that happened was this Jaishul Hind kind of stuff started popping up. So there was one Jaishul Hind that claimed responsibility for this. Then a second Jaishul Hind came up saying that we are not claiming responsibility. The guys who are claiming it are wrong. It's like that movie Special 26. Hum asli CBI wale hai na? Hum CBI hai asli wale. So in this case, these guys said hum Jaishul Hind hai asli wale. Frankly, nobody as yet knows that there is an organization called Jaishul Hind. Then more information came out of Mumbai police that is now increasingly looking unconvincing. I'm not going so far as to say it's red herring, but it's funny. Something is not adding up, because information came out that, oh, this Jaishul Hind Telegram channel on which this claim was put out was actually set up by somebody in Tihar jail or close to Tihar jail. And this information, Mumbai police sources claimed that they had found from a private IT investigating agency who they had engaged. Now, next day came the denial from some Jaishul Hind channel. So we don't know what happened, but in the middle, another game was playing out. And that game was about the ownership of the car. And I know that all of you are reading parts of the story, and I suspect that most of you are as cluttered in your head about this story as I am, or maybe I am even more cluttered than you. So what I've done is, because I've read up everything and we have a stellar correspondent right now in Mumbai investigating this story, Ananya Bhardwaj, who's a domain specialist who works central agencies, crime, terrorism. She's homegrown. She trained at our journalism school at the Indian Express. She's now working with us, and she has broken some stories. She also broke the story that we published last evening on the print.in on the post-mortem report of the owner of the car whose body was found. And I'm coming to that. So then the story gets a twist. The story gets a twist because this is an identified vehicle. This vehicle is traced to a man called Mansukh Hiren. Mansukh Hiren lives in far away in Thane. In fact, the other side of Thane, Naupada, that area. Now, if you know the geography of Bombay, then you will know that Thane is a city by itself. In fact, it's a large city. But you can drive from Thane to Mumbai and Mumbai to back. Many people commute also. So this car belonged to this man called Mansukh Hiren, who has a motor mechanics workshop, also a shop that refurbishes a lot of old cars. This belonged to him. And then he surfaced because he's the owner. He was questioned by the police. He came to the police and this went on for a few days. And he said his cover story, which looked so unconvincing that I don't even think his mom would have bought it. Why Bombay police should have bought it, or Mumbai police should have bought it, I don't know. Mumbai police is not so naive. He said that he was driving in this car on the night before it was found at the Ambani house, that is 25th of Feb. So night before he was driving, the car broke down at Mulund checkpoint, Mulund Naka, that is approaching the Eastern Expressway in Mumbai, which I believe has just been named after Vilas Rao Deshmukh, the former Chief Minister of Mumbai. And he left the car there and he came to the city, apparently to Crawford Market area, where the police headquarters is, in an Ola, and then went back, never picked it up. Next day, he says, when he came to look for it, he found the car was missing and registered a missing car report. Now, tell me this, would somebody who's an expert motor mechanic, who runs a motor workshop, a sizable, successful motor workshop, will leave his car overnight in Mumbai, any place? Even an ordinary person will not do it. You will find some way of doing it, or if you do it, you will take some precautions so it is not stolen. So first of all, that story doesn't gel. Then one after the other, things began to get complicated. Now this man, on the fourth evening, 4th of March, he left home, 8:30, saying somebody has called me, I am going to meet the person. His wife, Vimla, thinks he was going to meet his friends in Mumbai police, particularly his friend, assistant inspector, and Mumbai's favorite or famous or infamous encounter cop, Inspector Sachin Waze, who's a well-known encounter cop in Mumbai. When he was in his prime, that is about 20 years back, about 60 encounters were credited on him. Those days, encounters were seen as a good thing, as they are in UP right now. And then it led to trouble because there was a Ghatkopar bombing in December 2002, after which four persons were arrested by Mumbai police. This was a group led by Sachin Waze because he was dealing with these terror incidents. Of the four people arrested, one, Khwaja Yunus, disappeared. And this is one of those typical filmy stories, once again, which I say that even your mother won't believe, and I keep dragging in the mothers because they tend to be very much more trusting of their children than the other parent. That's the father, at least that is the conventional wisdom. So even if even your mother doesn't believe you, nobody will believe you. So the story was that these four people were being taken by a group of Mumbai policemen with Sachin Waze in the lead to Aurangabad. On the way, this gentleman, Khwaja Yunus, tried to escape, and he escaped and he remained escaped. He was presumed dead. And then an inquiry was ordered because the previous day, the other three said that they had found him stripped and badly beaten up and badly thrashed in police custody. So that led to the suspension of Sachin Waze. He remained suspended for 16 years. In the process, during that period, he joined Shiv Sena. And as happens when people who are accused of all kinds of crimes join the BJP and have a Ganga Snan and become pristine and clean, the same thing happened with him once he joined Shiv Sena, because the moment Shiv Sena got power of its own, that is when they got the government after they got rid of Devendra Fadnavis, among the first things they did, or early things they did, was to reinstate him in police service. And how did they reinstate him in police service? By saying that this is the COVID time, we are short of people, we need all hands on the deck. So why not? We need Sachin Waze also. What he's been doing since then, I will tell you, and then you will again understand. This is again a story that you will not even tell to your mom. While I keep on telling you this mysterious story, I can also tell you that I also have a very special audience today. You can see him sitting right behind me. He's curious, but he can keep his eyes shut and still listen to us very carefully. He is Mr. Denzel, one of our cats. He usually hangs around when we record our Cut the Clutter on our terrace. Anyway, thank you, Mr. Denzel, for being there. Now, coming back to Mansukh Viren. Mansukh Viren's body, fourth night he left home at 8:30. His body was then found a day later floating in the creek. This is a place, if you understand Bombay's geography, and we'll try and explain it on the screen with a very rough map, near a place called Kalwa Creek. Kalwa Creek near Riti Bandar. This body was found, this 48-year-old man. Now, it was said that he had left a suicide note, that he was being harassed by the police, so he was committing suicide. You could have said yes, because since the 25th of February, since the car was found, he was under the microscope and he was being questioned again and again and again. And when someone like that is questioned, so the combination of the circumstances of what was being attempted, the severity of the crime, the identity of the victim or the target, given all that and the social stature of the person, you can presume that Bombay police, if Mumbai police was interrogating him, they were not being kind to him, they were not being hospitable to him. So initially it looked logical that maybe he was so harassed that he killed himself, and that's when Devendra Fadnavis, the former chief minister, first made his charges. Initial implication was that maybe police had treated him so rudely, and when he said that Sachin Waze is to blame for it, even I had presumed that what he's saying is that perhaps police had been too tough on this man and he panicked into killing himself. And then this gets more complicated, because as his body was found, both Mumbai police and NIA, and I know it all from our correspondent Ananya Bhardwaj, whose stories I will share with you. I've had a long conversation with her. Mumbai police also came to the conclusion that this body had not floated very far. Apparently, there is also a story, very good coverage in Indian Express also by Mohammad Thawer. I will share a couple of those stories also with you. That body got washed up, because before the body could get washed away into the sea, low tide came in. So body got seen. When the body was seen, they found the body had a mask on. Now, if somebody was killing himself, why would he keep a mask on to protect himself from COVID? इतना भी दिमाग ख़राब नहीं हुआ है, जब मरना ही है तो कैसे ही मर जाओ. एंड मोर ओवर, इफ यू ड्राउनिंग योर सेल्फ टू डेथ, वाई डू यू नीड टू वरी अबाउट कोविड? कोविड विल स्टिल टेक 3 weeks इफ एट ऑल टू किल यू, एंड दैट ऑल्सो 1 in 100 डजंट जेल. द नेक्स्ट थिंग, देयर वॉज पीसेज ऑफ क्लॉथ एंड ए हैंडकरचीफ स्टफ्ड इन हिज माउथ. नोबडी स्टफ्स हिज माउथ विद क्लॉथ when he decides to kill himself, because then you think that the earlier you drown, the better. So clothes are stuffed into your mouth to prevent water from getting in, because when water gets in, nobody's trying to save your life. When water gets in, the body floats. I'm sorry, these details are gory, but this is murder, terrorism, blackmail, a mixed up police force, everything, terrible politics, all rolled into one. This is a first-class clutter story. So, cloth has been stuffed into his mouth, probably so that his body would not suck in water and thereby float on the surface of the water. So, body will not be found. Bodies ultimately get found, but not for a few days, by which time excitement about the story would have gone. But it so happened, no matter how clever a criminal is, most criminals are brilliant, but they do make some mistakes, they get caught, or the elements, God, somebody turns on them, and then something goes wrong. So what went wrong in this case was that low tide came in and this body washed up, and so they could find this body. Now the post-mortem report, which Ananya scooped yesterday, and I'm sharing that story with you, the post-mortem report showed initially, first of all, prima facie, there is no evidence of drowning. What it does show, on the other hand, is some abrasions on the face. Two on the left side, one on the right side, one on the nose. It looks like maybe he struggled when somebody tried to catch him. He struggled and somebody gave him a few, like the movies, and then overpowered him and then tied him up and then stuffed his mouth with stuff and then killed him. Killed him. How killed him? We don't know. The body also shows the post-mortem very gory, that some foul smelling liquid was coming out of his nostrils, that his body had already begun to decompose, so it had already been in water for about 8 to 12 hours. His skin was peeling, there was cyanosis or bluing of the nails, but There was no water anywhere in his body, nothing in lungs, heart, belly, nowhere. That means he had not sucked in water and he had not drowned on prima facie evidence. Now what the forensic scientists are saying is that to conclusively say whether it was drowning or not, we have to put it to diatom test. Now what is a diatom test? Diatoms are the smallest of algae, very small, very microscopic. So what happens is that a lot of the water bodies, the seas as well as lakes, rivers, have these diatoms or these algae that we can't see with our eyes. But when human beings go into water, particularly if they drown, they swallow it. When they swallow it, these algae are so small that they get absorbed in our system. So you can then pick these up from our body. So in his case, forensic scientists are now searching for these diatoms. They've kept pieces of his sternum. Sternum is a bone right here in the shoulder. That bone, they will now check out if that has any evidence of diatoms. Once again, I apologize to you. This is the autopsy of a brutally, violently killed person. So it is now very clear that, quite evident, that he did not kill himself, that he was killed. Now, if somebody is killed, the killer has to have a motive. If so, what was the motive? Who could have this motive and why? Now, these are stories we don't know. That's why this remains so cluttered. Now, I will take you to a couple more dimensions of this story. There are some very interesting elements, because 8:30 he leaves home. After that, he is not seen. Around 11 o'clock, his son calls him on his phone. Nobody answers the phone or the phone is switched off. But sometime at night, around time he may have died, both his phones ring and two of them receive phone calls. One rings in a place about 40 kilometers away in Virar. Virar, as you know, all Mumbai Walas know where Virar is. But for the rest of the country, actor Govinda made Virar famous because he was called Virar Ka Chokra, because he came from them, from that sort of very lower middle class or in fact slum type locality. So that is about 40 kilometers from where this body was found. And then another call from the other phone, which is 10 kilometers further away from Virar. So this now looks like this was a multiple series of red herrings that somebody was creating. So the police would think, or investigators would think, that he was there and then he came here and killed himself, basically so that people will not find his body and the evidence in time. If the body was not found for 2 weeks, the story was over. Nobody would have talked about it. People would have said, kahan gayab ho gaya hai? Maybe there would have been a couple of prime time programs saying the man who disappeared, and then the story would have died. But story did not die, because you know what? The dead tell tales. The dead almost always tell tales. And this is what happened in this case. Now, this Jaishul Hind story, if you ask me, it's not convincing. This Jaishul Hind telegram channel was created on one of the dark web platforms. Now, dark web platforms, you will say, yes, terrorists have access to that, but so do sort of the dark elements in the law enforcement authority, particularly anti-terrorism police, etc., plus a lot of private people can have access to dark web. So we don't know who's done it. Second, if terrorists were to do it, if Jaishul Hind or Jaishul Pakistan or Jaishul Cheen or Jaishul Afghanistan or Jaishul wherever in the world, or Jaishul wherever the hell in the world had to do this, why would they first give a warning by leaving a couple of gelatin sticks? Because terrorists are not trying to get money. Terrorists have to make a dhamaka. So even if they had just rigged some kind of a fuse with these few gelatin sticks and blown up this car, even if they had not hurt anybody, a car blowing up with explosives on that street, in that area of Mumbai, would have scared not just the entire country but the whole world, because Mumbai has a history of 26/11. So terrorists want headlines. They would have got headlines like that. Why would they waste their money and time writing this very unconvincing looking warning and asking for money in cryptocurrency, knowing fully well that this will be traced? So it doesn't seem convincing to me that any terrorists did any of this. There was also a message that said on this Telegram channel that, you know, we placed this car there as a warning, and the brother who placed this car has reached the safe house same. I don't think terrorists work like that, not even in teleserials on OTT platforms, not even in that silly Sacred Games does anybody work like that. So this is not the way any terrorist organization will work. Now you have to understand a little bit more about this Sachin Waze character. Now he is somebody who you saw quite prominently in those pictures and videos when Arnab Goswami was being arrested. He has sizable biceps. You can see that with an AK in his hands, he could be more than a handful, particularly either you were a bad guy who he was targeting or you were somebody he was targeting nevertheless or any which way. But you can see quite clearly that he was Shiv Sena's favorite because he was a party man for so many years. He had resigned from his police job. He was under investigation. Still, he was taken back. He was taken back on the excuse that he was needed during COVID period because Mumbai police was short of people. They needed just anybody, as I told you earlier, all hands on the deck. But as soon as he came on the deck, it looked like he was the only cop they had. And he, it's as if he outranked everybody in that police, including the commissioner, because he had every key case that you and I have followed, every key case out of Mumbai that has made national headlines. And I will list some for you. There was the case, there was raid on hookah parlors in Mumbai. He led it. There was that case of Mumbai police launching against celebrities who apparently had fake social media followers. He headed it. There was the case of those fake emails involving Hrithik Roshan and you know who. He was handling it. There was that Anwar Nayak suicide case in which Arnab Goswami was arraigned. Who was handling it? He was handling it. He arrested Arnab Goswami. So it looked like there was no case in Mumbai that anybody else was handling. Dilip Chhabria, the man who became famous for making customized old cars or customized unique cars, he got into trouble for some fraud. He's in jail. That case also, he was investigating. Cooked up TRP case, that also he was investigating. In a police force so large and boasting so many brilliant people, how could it be that they had only one officer and that too at this level who was handling everything? So once again, there is no doubt that he was a favorite, political favorite in more ways than one. And he is a very central part to what is not gelling with this story. So in conclusion, I would say that the center has taken the right call by handling the case to NIA. What has happened right now is there is a dichotomy and there is confusion. The confusion is that the case of the car and explosives being found close to Mukesh Ambani's house, that case has been given to NIA because where explosives are involved, then center can take suo moto action and hand the case over to the NIA. Whereas the death or the murder, I would say, of this Mansukh Hiren, that is being investigated by the anti-terrorism squad of Mumbai police. Sachin Waze has been taken off that case, but I'm not surprised if I learn, and I'm quite sure I know, that NIA is also asking him not very polite questions right now. Because it is important now that one agency investigates both these cases, because both of these are linked cases, and his body is found floating in the creek with abrasions on his face, with cloth stuffed in his mouth, with both his phones making phone calls around that time, half an hour apart from places 40 to 50 kilometers apart. It's all a setup. Somebody wanted to kill him to buy his silence, because somebody wanted to kill his story. Somebody also wanted to make sure his body will not be found. That game has gone wrong, and I don't think the country can wait for long before this is unraveled. So thank you very much for watching.